I think we're just about ready here. I got all my wool, got my wood, spruce, birch, yes, good. Packed ice, yes. Take a swig of coffee before we begin. Man, I really gotta change my socks. They stink so bad. Alright, get into position. Hello, everybody. This is Etho, and welcome back, guys, to the HermitCraft server. How you doing? What's going on? I'm cooking hot here. I'm sweating like crazy. It is so hot. You know, when you think of Canada, a lot of you, I don't know if you just heard that right now. Usually, I record with my window shut, but in Canada, you often think of cold, ice cold winters, but in summer gets really hot here, and people generally don't have air conditioning like myself. So I'm just dying here, sweating so bad. Got shorts on, got my window open, and it's still like 30 Celsius, or I don't know what that is, Fahrenheit, probably 90 Fahrenheit or whatever. Anyways, let's get to it here. So I asked you guys what kind of statue we should put in our banquet hall here. I got some pretty good suggestions. One of them was Charizard, the Pokemon dragon. Tried building that, but failed big time, so I had to do something else. The other big thing that was suggested was we build some kind of... Okay, we're good. Some kind of dwarf statue here. And I started designing one, guys, but as I was building it, it sort of looked like Notch. So I changed it to a Notch statue, and I looked at some pictures of Notch, and I saw one where he's wearing a green shirt, so then I put a green shirt on him, and now he kind of looks like a leprechaun as well. So it's like a dwarven Notch leprechaun we're going to build here. Yes, it's going to be amazing. All right, so give him some fancy socks. Green shirt, and we want to go for an epic beard, guys, so let's start it low here. Like, is that too low? That might be too low. I think we gotta go up one more. Okay, I had to just make sure I got the dimensions right, but that's Notch's epic beard right there, represented in its full glory. And we're about to get technical. Oh yeah, late night crew. I didn't even see you joined. Yeah, technical Minecraft right now. If you have very little space to work with and a beard of this size, you need very tiny arms. Very tiny. Let's go for something like that, maybe? I'm very great at building statues, guys. Look at this. Look at these amazing arms. It's like Notch wants to hug us right now. This is how you build statues. All right, let's give him some face. Next, we will shape it like this. Now, I looked, and Notch actually has brown eyes from what I could see, but we're going to give him blue eyes regardless. Okay, I just went ahead and finished building it here. So this is the grand reveal. Are you ready to see it? Here we go. Oh man, I love this statue. I don't know what it is about it, but it makes me laugh when I see it. Yeah, so that's Notch on his throne. Gave him a fedora too. It kind of looks like a top hat though, but you know, we're limited with how accurate we can do this. Gave him blue eyes just because it pops more than brown eyes, I think. You know, I never actually did try brown eyes, but I'm assuming it would. I'm going to steal your vision for a second, Notch. One second. Don't worry. Oh, I don't have brown on me. Oops. I guess we could try dark oak. Like brown wool I was going to try. But this will probably work too. Alright. And... it's not terrible. Yeah. It's more accurate, probably. But I do like the blue. I think I'm going to put the blue ones back, just because they pop more. And you know what we should do? We should give him a cane. Because why not? He's got the top hat slash fedora. And I would love to put like a cake in his other hand, like on top here, but I don't have any cake. And I'm gonna try something here. These other guys are online. I think, did they leave? No. Anybody wants to sell me some cake? I'd pay 5 diamonds each. And I need about, let's go for 10. We'll see if anything happens with that. We need cake for the tables here, and we need a cake for Notch, so I don't have the stuff to make it, is my problem. So if we can do a trade here, that would be perfect. Sweet. Let me know when you are ready to trade. Oh, do you have it already? Oh, do you have it made already? Did they have cake just laying around? Unbelievable. Okay, we're gonna head over to the Nether Hub probably in just a second. You know, I can't decide. Should we put ears on this guy on Notch? I think they might look a bit weird. All right. I probably just made their night too. 50 diamonds for nothing. That looks pretty funny. If the statue wasn't funny enough, that definitely adds to it. They're really pointy though, aren't they? Hey. Cha-ching. Maybe I shouldn't have paid them first. Oh yeah, those are the real deal. These are freshly baked today, right? Oh no, they're giving the diamonds back. I don't want the diamonds. No. Yeah. If I keep the diamonds, I gotta find somewhere to put them, and they're just gonna take up space. Excellent. They took them from Doc. Does Doc have cake? Oh, snap. All right, maybe I'll pay the diamonds to Doc then if they just snagged them from Doc. Oh, maybe from the villagers? I think you can get them from villagers, can't you? Okay, I see. Oh, yeah, it is from the farmer. Aha. All right. Super generous. All right, guys, I think this is about it. I think we just about got it here. Okay, cakes are in place. I've been working on the banquet hall as well. Got the redstone installed on our food dispenser here. So we're gonna load it up with some fish. All right. Oh, let's get our torch back. Okay, so you ready to see the banquet hall here? Cakes on the table. I ate a few of them. Slightly. Oh, we got a skeleton in here. Hey, you, get out of here. You're gonna interrupt my showing here. All right, so this is it, guys. I put in a birchwood floor. Thought that looked pretty nice. Notch has his cake in his left hand, cane in the right hand, and food on the table. Did the chandelier thing after all, so we got chandeliers on both sides here. I'm not very good at building chandeliers. Just a very basic style to it. And I decided to do something with the ceiling here because it looked really rough the way it was, so I got it kind of going up in the middle and makes a notch a little bit more revealing here too when you come in. There's no like stuff blocking the view of him, which is cool. And put a carpet in underneath the table here. But I need more materials here. Like, I didn't have enough to finish on this side. Oh, yeah, we need a few more things done here. I tried working in some plants and stuff, but I really don't like them. They just somehow are not fitting in with this build, so we're gonna not do that. So let's try it out here. So the idea is, we're out of food, right? I go through food really quickly. I'm hungry. Oh, I got a stack on me still. Oops. Let's pretend I don't, though. So if we run out of food ever, we're gonna come up to this point, and then we'll decide to go this way into the banquet hall. Be greeted by Notch there. Oh, let's close this up too. There we go. And is it gonna work? It doesn't work at all. All right. Perfect redstone. Perfect. Did I miss? Oh, I did miss. Whoops. There's supposed to be a wire underneath here. All right. Let's try that again. So we'll be in the carts. Oh no, Notch! Notch, give me my fish! Oh, snap. Oh, snappers. Chew with your mouth closed, Notch. What are you doing? Oh, he's not dropping them. So yeah, we got the ice stream up there. We might have to. Oh, this might not work. I should have maybe tested this before we finished the build. That looks a little bit strange, but maybe this will work. Let's hope. Oh. Oh, I think it's gonna do it. Are any getting stuck up here is the question. Let's just double check. Yeah, they're all coming out. Great. Okay, that'll do it then. Woohoo! So Notch vomits fish or whatever food we have. Uh-oh. Oh, my inventory's full. That's why it's doing that. Okay. All good. Excellent. So we'll get our fish, shut them off, and then depending which way we go here, we'll go to two different locations back in the cave there. So, oops. This way doesn't really go anywhere. And the other way doesn't really go anywhere at the moment. But let's just go check out the other side here. I still got to do a little bit of work up here, as you can see. But let's go down again. All right, so this way, this is a little bit more finished. Oh, there's a cart up here. So the track will go out this way. It'll do a bend, and then it'll go straight here. And let's just see where this takes us if we go out this way. Right back to here. Okay. Do we want to come back out this way? Is it too close to this track? Maybe that's a good idea. Because we could have this track go straight across here and then another junction meeting back up. Yes, I like that. Okay. That's probably what we'll do. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, when you build a room this big, there's so much you can do. Like, this roof is really plain still. I want to add more detail to it. These walls are pretty plain. But how much time should we actually spend on this is the question. I don't know. I think I'm just gonna. Because I kind of wanted to just move on to something else here. But maybe we'll just do a little bit of cleanup here. A couple more things. Oh yeah, there's so much to do. That's still rough over there. Let's try here. Let's figure out the lighting maybe, because that's pretty important. I don't want to have torches all over the floor like this. So if we take these all out, how dark is it actually gonna be here? I hid torches behind these. You're not gonna see them when you go by. And we got the chandeliers. Oh, there's still a bunch here. Oh, it's getting dark in here. Let's check our block lighting. We are 5, 6. Oh, that's pretty dark. And we still got a bunch around here. Okay. But I put like two on the table here. I think if we did that, it would be pretty good. Oh, I took out most of them on this side, actually. Yeah, this room's a little dark without torches. If we hid some lighting under the rail here, that would help too, because it would be like kind of this bright. And then we have. Oh, this cake's kind of in the way. I want to put a torch up here. Let's see. Do I have any fences left? Let's just double check. We should put a torch behind here. I missed that. And there. Good. All right. Did you guys see? They actually posted some screenshots of the end again on the Reddit. And there's definitely been some changes to this game in 1.9. Can hardly wait till it gets released. I think it should be fairly soon because Minecon's happening soon, and they usually, like, if they wait a long time for a release, They usually release it at Minecon then, so I'm hoping, or around Minecon. Oh, that cake. I don't like breaking the cakes. They're so valuable, so precious. But yeah, we might get the update soon, I'm really hoping. I really wish they would go back to doing the snapshots like they used to. I think that was better. Alright, so that's pretty good lighting. Is there any dark spots? It's okay if we have a little bit of darkness. I'm not going for full, like, no mob spawning. I would like to, but that's pretty difficult to do without spamming torches everywhere. We got, like, torches hidden on notch here. Alright. Yeah, I think we're good here. Let's get rid of this one. There's another one hidden there, so that's fine. We got the fire up there. Yeah, feels pretty good. Okay, so we got to figure something out here, guys. I want your feedback on this idea. Whether it's a good idea or not, I need to know. And we need to decide this soon because it's going to factor into how we build the rest of our base here. Should we build a storage room or this is alternative, like, should we turn each of these rooms we build into a partial storage room? Like, for example, this is the food room, right? The banquet hall. This is where we come to get our food, but an alternative is we could also use this as our, as the place we go to store food as well. Like, maybe we just have a double chest here or something underneath notch. So, you know, if we have carrots or watermelon or whatever, steak, throw it in the chest, and then if we ever need to pick up food for something, then we come into this room, grab it, and get out. Now, the cool thing about that is it will make us move around our base a lot and check things out, actually use rooms, like, and visit them often. The downside is, if we're doing something, it might get a little bit frustrating if we have to run around our whole base here to collect materials to do what we want to do. Alright, so that's the logic or the thinking behind it. What do you guys think? Should we have a storage room, or should we separate things into, like, specific rooms? Let me know, okay? I think we will take a break from the banquet hall for today, though. It's basically done. There's just some little refinements we need to do, but we don't have wool, we don't have gold for rails, we don't have jack-o'-lanterns for lighting, stuff like that. We need things, guys, is what I'm getting at. So maybe for the rest of this episode, we will work on a farm project. We need to set up farms around this place too, not just like silly little builds like that. We need actual things that work. So maybe we will try to build a pumpkin and melon farm today. Should be a pretty simple project. Do I have a card on me? I don't. Darn it! We got rails all over the place here, and I still run around all the time. Things aren't set up quite right. Oh, we have pumpkins, and we have melons. Sweet. All right. We'll still build a farm. Let's see. Azuma left this for me. Maybe we should check this out, too. I think it was Azuma. Yeah, it says Azuma. Dear Hermit, the Iron Ball Stadium is having a giveaway contest. You have the opportunity to win a pitchside executive box. This unfurbished room has an excellent view of the game and is ready for owners to move in and make it their own. PTO. I found out that means... Wait. I thought it was turn page over. Why is it PTO? Page turnover. To enter, simply visit the stadium and enter your name into the raffle chest at the stadium entrance. At a later date, winners will be selected at random. Okay, I might want to do that then. Might want to do that. But let's look into this farm idea first. Let's see, we have a little bit of stuff here. Oh, good, we have more power rails. Very good. Oh, more melon. Okay, we gotta figure out how we're designing it first. So, do we have room to work around here? We need, like, an open spot. Not really. Let's see, do we have everything we need here to figure this out first? We need pistons. We need sticky pistons. Alright, I have an idea in mind here. We just need the stuff to do it. Alright, let's head back. There is definitely some sticky pistons in one of these chests. I think it's the one right over here. I do a lot of running around just looking for stuff. Maybe it is a bad idea not to store everything in one room, because I have a feeling I'll do a lot of that if we don't. But I am curious what you guys think about the idea. All right, we can work down here. It's kind of flat. So we could have, like, detector rails. Here, let's clean this up a little bit. For our pumpkin and melon farm, we want to do it so we don't have to get out of our cart to harvest the crops, right? So we could do something like this where we have detector rails, maybe a section of 8 of them, and boosters before and after that so the cart's moving quick enough to get across. Nighttime. All right. Get this here. And then we will have it so the pumpkins and the melons, they grow on the left and the right of the track, like so. And to harvest them, we want, let's see, we will have to have dirt on both sides then so that the melons and the pumpkins actually grow there. All right, so let's do that. Oh, and we want pistons underneath. Let's do that before we forget. Let's just do one side of the track to speed this up. All right, so we'll have 8 pistons on both sides, but we'll just put it on one for now. Okay, and the plants will be over here to grow the melons and the pumpkins, so we need another row of dirt. And we can put the water somewhere around here. We don't have to worry about that too much. Now, if we have pumpkins on there and a cart goes by, let's make a cart real quick. My inventory, man. I cannot even tell you guys how big of a problem this is becoming for me. I always have so much stuff on me, and like I'll put down a chest to drop stuff off, and that fills up like instantly. And then I have the same problem again. So I make another chest, and the same thing over and over. I never have enough inventory space, no matter what I do here. Okay, so if this goes by, these do not get triggered. So what I think we have to do is actually put redstone underneath here. Let's just double check. So this will update the pistons because they're being powered like a bud right now, I believe. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so now when the cart goes over those, it should trigger the pistons. It's a little trick. Oh, where's my cart? Let's power it this way so we can just push it back. All right, is this going to work? Yeah, that works. Okay, good. The other thing is, though, we want the pumpkins to not fly all over the place. We want to be able to collect them as we go by, hopefully. Here, let's see if we can grab these. We have 56 right now. We picked up none. Darn it. Oh, and 2 of them launched all the way over here. Okay, so that's bad. I think what we can do, I think I've experimented with this before. I don't think we can put solid blocks, but we can put glass over the plants. Like, there'll be plants over here. I think if you use solid blocks, the plants don't grow or they can't grow, if I remember correctly. But if we do glass blocks above, I think that makes it so the items won't bounce to over here. Let's try this out again. Where's the cart? There it is. Okay. And yeah, okay. That looks good. They all ended up here, so we'd be able to grab them. But I don't know if we can make it so we can grab it when we go by the first time. Yeah, we got none of those. All right. You know, this might be one of those occasions, guys. You always tell me I overcomplicate things. Let's try this now. Oh, we didn't get 2 of them. We might need to move this back one more. Let's try it out now. Yeah, we need a little bit of time for us to get those first ones, it seems. But if we have too much time, the pistons are going to retract, and then we won't be able to get the pumpkins at the end. So we can't make this section too long. So yeah, what I did, I got rid of all the detector rails. We just need one, right? We don't get that cool effect where they go up as we go by, but this is fine. We don't need anything too crazy here. So just got that. Lowered the pistons by one, so the plants will actually grow at this level. And we still have a space there for them. So we should hopefully get all eight. We have 56 right now. Yeah, I think that's fine, right? Let's try that one more time because that pumpkin landed on this block. I'm worried that might have just been lucky. Because like we want to get all the drops if possible. That's the goal, of course. Okay, that time it was. Yeah, we got it. Okay, good. So that'll work. All right, cool. So we got our design worked out for that melon farm, and the plan is to build like a tunnel, a melon tunnel with pumpkins and stuff. I had a really hard time deciding where to put it though. So I started this one down here, started chiseling away, and was like, you know what? Maybe this isn't the best place for it. So I changed my mind. I'm gonna have to refill this in with stone or something later. Decided to go this way instead. So the track is gonna bend around. Connect to here. This will be our first detector. Then there'll be a section of eight here. And I was gonna go this way, but then it ends up being like a really short tunnel, like only three sections. So instead, we're gonna go one more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then we will bend this way. Let's see. I think we want a little bit of space here. Yeah, I think the tunnel will go like this then. All right, so the next section would be about here. And we would want to go at least two and then bend back. So we should end up, let's just head back out of here. The plan is to go in from here and we should come out over there on that platform somewhere. Yes, that is exactly what has happened here. So we enter here. We have one, two sections going this way, then two going this way, and one going this way, and we leave right over here. Somehow we have to work it into this pathway here as well. And that should be pretty good. So it'll be a way of getting from there to this area of the base. And I'm a little bit short on supplies here, unfortunately, but we're gonna try maybe get one section up and running here. We're also running a little bit low on time. But let's see. Do that. Rails. Yeah, we can have power rails all the way. That's right. How do we power these? How do we power the power rails? Let's just put this there for now. And one over here. I want to make sure we can collect all the pumpkins here before we commit to this, okay? Because it's going around a bend here. It might slow the cart down a little bit more than I would like, and we might get a different result. So, see if we go up to speed enough. Yeah, we got them all, right? Yeah, we did. Okay, good. No, we didn't get that one. What? What happened? That was the easy one. I thought we were gonna miss this one. All right, let's try one more time. Why you do that? We missed that. Oh, you know what? I never put the blocks over there, so it's bouncing where it's not supposed to. That should be good though. So what we'll do? Maybe plant melon on one side, pumpkin on the other. Would be pretty traditional way of doing it. Could hide some water, maybe. We'd only need. We'd need two water sources, wouldn't we? Yeah, we could just put it over here, though. So this should hydrate the land. And crafting table. Do I need to make another crafting table? Got them all over the place. I know we do. All right. Can never have enough, though. They should just make it so you can, man. I'm telling you guys, I love that about HermitCraft a lot. Like, Once you got the crafting table, it was built into your GUI. You didn't have to go find it every time. It was just there. This turns into a 3x3, and it is amazing. it's so much more convenient. Okay, so melons will go here. And might need to put lighting in the side here. Nope. Loud noises outside. I have sweated more today than I have all year, I think. It is getting nasty. I never, you know, there's things you don't think about in life, like how I wish my chair was made of a different fabric at this moment. Something not so leathery would be nice, but for any other day, it's perfectly fine. Yeah, so I think that'll work. I think that'll grow stuff. Alright. And yeah, that's the basic design for it. So I gotta collect more rails and stuff to finish this up. I think maybe we'll just wrap it up here for today, though. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you have ideas for our base, maybe we should dye this too. I don't like how the clear glass looks anymore. It's like I can't use it anymore. I gotta use stained glass all the time now. Alright, but yeah, we got Notch done. We got our banquet hall pretty much all complete here as well, which is great. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day. Take care. Bye-bye.